delta y sin y menos sin cos por plus nothing I see. If I take minus sign common, it will be negative, this will be positive, and this minus sign I have taken here. Okay, so I have multiplied by minus sign, numerator and denominator. We have this and this here. Okay, so this it will be this negative, this positive, this is sign pi per delta y into cos pi. This will be positive, this will be negative by multiplying by minus. We get what? In the denominator delta y tends to 0, we are having sine, let me write here, y per delta y into sine y, okay, and into delta y, okay, still I have provided the denominator. What is left in the denominator? This is sine a cos b minus cos a sine, so this is sine a minus b, sine y per delta y minus y, formula of sine a minus b, okay. Sine a cos b, this is sine a cos b minus cos a sine b. This is sine a minus b. Here a is y per delta y and b is y. So we are left with delta y in the denominator, sine delta y. Now, taking delta y of the numerator in the denominator and apply the formula of limit delta f tends to 0, delta y tends to 0. So we are left with sine y per delta y. Sine y. This limit is applied in the no. In the denominator we are left with sine delta y. This sine delta y of numerator this one. This or let me multiply this by and divide by multiply, multiply and divide this delta y and this delta y by numerator are cancelled out. That's okay. So applying the limit here. Let me write it again. Limit delta y tends to 0, delta x tends to 0, sine y per delta y, and then we tend to sine y which is free from delta y. Now in that denominator we have limit delta y tends to 0, sine delta y from delta y 1. We are left with sine y into sine y. That means sine square y, sine square theta. Now we have convert this into cosecant x. Why? Because we got inverse axis to this for this for minus sine. Here it was minus sine. So this is minus sine square. Why this is minus sine? Okay. It's minus sine. Okay, so this is with minus 1 upon cosecant square y is to be converted into cot 1 plus cot 2 square y. Cosecant square theta is 1 plus cot square theta. Okay. This is equal to minus 1 upon cos cot y is x. This is 1 upon 1 plus x with negative sign. So, differentiation of cot inverse x is minus 1 to root of x square, just similar to tan inverse x. Okay. Now, let me, what is negative sign? Now, let me take the other two, secant inverse x and cosecant inverse x. So, there are two left two terms. And this I have to take, otherwise, lecture will be very lengthy. In the next lecture, I have to talk about the remaining questions of these. Okay. Or, I mean, these questions I have to take in the next lecture. So, this is the 9th one, let y equal to second inverse x. Okay, this implies that again second y equal to x or x plus delta x equal to second y plus delta y or delta x equal to second y plus delta y minus second y. Okay. Now here we have y per delta y equal to second inverse x per delta x. Second equation, this is the first one. Subtracting first from second, we get delta y is equal to second inverse x per delta x minus second inverse x. You see, subtracting first One second, we get this. Okay, with this divided by delta x, both sides delta x, and from the limit, limit delta x delta 0, delta y equals delta x. Now second inverse x, this one is y plus delta y, so limit delta x will be 0, from the limit. Second inverse x is y plus delta y, minus y divided by delta x. We are left with limit delta x will be 0, delta y oblique delta x. Now substitute value of delta x this. Substitute the value of this, from delta x to 0, this is delta y. Oblique delta x is the second y plus delta y minus second y. Now converting this into tilde matrix, if we change what is that, cosine, this is limit delta x to 0, delta y oblique 1 after 1 cos y plus delta y minus 1 from cos y. So taking the LCM and take that LCM denominator, we get that matrix. Okay, so take LCM, delta x to 0. This is delta y denominator. We will get cos y plus delta y to cos y. Taking the LCM and it will come in the denominator. So this is cos y minus cos y per delta y. This cos y per delta y will come here, cos y here. Take the LCM, this is the denominator. This is the second equation. Now let me, what is cos a minus cos b? Again, two sine sine. Here it will be positive. This is limit delta x tend to 0. This is delta y into cos y per delta y. Cos of y. In the denominator we have cos a minus cos b, that means 2 sine y plus delta y plus delta y plus y upon into sine here b minus a. So b is y plus delta y minus y upon 2 y. We cancel out positive, negative, positive. So because here b is greater than this, so the, okay, we have applied that cos a minus cos b. The formula is sine 2 sine a plus b by 2 into sine b minus a by 2. This formula of trigonometry is this. Since cos a minus cos b is 2 sine a plus b by 2 into sine b minus a by 2. Here b was y plus delta y and a was y. This is positive. So we are left with limit delta x tends to 0. We have delta y into cos y plus delta y into cos y divided by 2 into sine y plus delta y upon 2 into sine delta y upon 2. Now applying the limit. If sine delta y upon 2, so take this delta y to the denominator of this and do this. Okay, so I can write it as delta x tends to 0 and delta y tends to 0. So in the numerator we have cos y per delta y into cos y divided by sine y per delta y upon 2. This delta y upon 2 also tends to 0. Okay, into 1 upon this one sine delta y upon 2, limit delta y upon 2 tends to 0, sine x delta x tends to 0, this is sine delta y upon 2. If I multiply this by, divide by delta y upon 2, so I'll multiply by delta y, oh sorry, this I've taken, dividing by delta y and multiplying by delta y, this delta y. This delta y, I have to cancel out this delta y. I have to divide by this delta y. This delta y will come in the pyramid focus. Okay, no change. Why? Because I have to divide by this and multiply by this delta by this delta by delta by this. This delta y is taken here. This is no change. Sorry, this delta y will this delta y cancel out. So multiply this. And that is a delta y. And after multiply delta y, so this delta y cancel out. And this delta y here, no change. I have just taken this delta y to the denominator of this m2. And this 2 was also here in the denominator. You are multiplied by 2 and divided by 2. 2 and this 2. It was here, it's cancelled out. So, that's why delta y upon 2 to the denominator of this and delta y upon 2. This is 1. We are left with cos delta y tends to 0. Here delta y and this also delta y tends to 0. Delta y by 2 comes to 0. So, we are left in the numerator of cos y into cos y. Cos y into cos y. In the denominator we have sine pi, this one, into 1, something else. Okay, so we are left with, now I have to convert this into cos pi upon sine pi is cot pi. Okay, and 1 is cos pi. So here is secant pi, secant pi. I have to convert cos pi into secant pi. Okay, so 1 from secant pi, okay, and sine pi upon. This is 10 by 10 by. I can write it as, let me write here. Okay, so I can write it as sine x upon, sorry, sine y upon cos y will change into this cos y can also come 1 upon sine y into cos y 1 upon cos y. For this cos pi and this cos pi can this cos pi and this cos pi I have taken to the denominator of this no change. That means 1 upon 10 pi into secant y. No change. For secant y 1 upon cos pi has come here. 10 pi sine pi upon cos pi is there. I have written down 10 pi. Why I have converted them 10 pi and secant y? For secant y is given as. Okay, so the value of 10 y is also to be converted into secant y. That means 1 upon the secant y as it is under root 1 secant square theta minus 1. That means 10 square theta. That is secant square theta. Secant square y minus 1. Okay, so this is nothing but 1 upon x into under root. X square minus 1. So this is 1 upon secant pi is x and under root x square minus 1. For secant square y minus 1, that means 10 is 10 by 10 by under root. Okay, so under root secant by under root. Okay, so under root is x square minus 1. So this is the definition of secant inverse x. So this is the second last. Now let me take last topic as well. What is that 10th one? 10th y equal to second inverse x. The definition of this also. Let me write it here. This is the last question. But let me be very happy. Give me that. What's it? I will take them. If y equal to cosine of inverse x, okay, then y plus delta y equal to cosecant inverse x per delta x. Simply that cosecant y equal to x or cosecant y per delta y equal to x per delta x or delta x equal to secant y per delta y minus cosecant y. Okay, so this and this is the second equation. This is the first one. In the same way, subtracting first from second, we get delta y is equal to second inverse x per delta x minus cosecant inverse x. Okay, dividing by delta x to both sides and putting the limits, limit delta x tends to 0. Here also limit delta x tends to 0. So this will be d by dx is equal to, now here substitute the value of cosec inverse x. This is y, limit delta epsilon 0. This is y for delta y minus y divided by delta. This limit delta epsilon 0. This is delta y upon delta x. Substitute the value of delta y. Sorry, delta x. This limit delta x 0. Delta y upon delta x is second y for delta y minus second y. Sorry, second y, of course, y. This is second y. We are limit delta x of 0. Change that to 1 point sine x, 1 point, and okay, sine y for delta y. Converting that into delta y, and we will get 1 point, let me write sine y for delta y minus 1 point sine y. Now taking the LCM, limit delta x to 0, this is delta y, and this LCM will come in the limit right there. Sine y for delta y into sine y divided by, okay, this is sine y minus sine y for delta y. So this is the next step of this. Now, next step of this. Now, this is sine A minus sine, but here A angle is smaller than y per delta y. So, I take the minus sign, or minus sign will come in this. Okay. Let me solve it with the property. This is limit delta x tend to 0. This is delta y sine y per delta y, repeating the same thing. In the denominator, we have sin A minus sin B, that means 2 cos y plus delta y plus y upon 2 into sin. This will be A minus B, that means y minus delta y upon 2. This will be negative, or function will be negative sign. So that means put here. So this is going to limit delta x tend to 0, or delta y tend to 0. This is delta y into sine y from delta y into sine y divided by the denominator we have 2 into cos of y plus delta y equal to, this is y plus, or 2y upon 2 means y only. Then the second step, this is sine, this is minus sine delta y upon negative. So let me write here the negative sign here. This is sine y per delta y. I'm sorry, y per delta y into sine y into sine y divided by, this is cos y plus delta y upon 2 into sine delta y upon 2 divided by delta y upon 2. This delta y, which was the numerator, has taken in the denominator of sine delta y equal to, and this 2, if I multiply by 2, this 2 was here, you can see out. Okay. So we are left with only this. And the limit here, okay. So prime the limit delta y by 2 times 0 and delta y times 0, limit delta y times 0 in the numerator is minus sine. Minus and update here, limit sine y per delta y into sine y is free from limit. Now here in this limit we have limit delta y by 2 times 0, delta x also turns to 0. So here delta x is not there. When delta x turns 0, delta y by 2 times 0, delta y turns 0. This means that we have sine by cos y per delta y equal to denominator into limit delta y by 2 times 0 sine delta y by 2 upon delta y by 2. This is 1. We are left with minus from minus sine y into sine y divided by cos y into 1. So again I have to convert into cosecant or cot. Okay. I can write it as sine square y, that means secant square theta, secant square y upon cos y, but I can write it as 1 upon, I can write it as cos y upon sine y, and the sine taken here, and upon sine y is 1 upon cosecant. This is 1 upon cosecant. Or let me write cosine by 1 upon sine by. So I have taken both the signs in the denominator of this denominator. Cos by 1 sine by 1 upon sine by. These two can be taken to the third step. So this is 1 upon cos by 1 sine by 10 by. This is the negative sign. Okay, cot by is nothing but cot by. It's cosecant y, this is cosecant y 1 upon sine y into cos y upon sine y cot y. Okay, so these are questions left over. Now cot y, sorry, cosecant y is 1, is x, cosec y is x, so I have to substitute this, and cot y, convert cot y into terms of cosec y, we are left with minus 1 upon cosec y is x, and the root, this is cosec square y minus 1, that is minus 1 upon cosec y is this, so this is x square minus 1. Okay, so differentiation of cosec inverse y, cosec inverse x is minus 1 upon x into x square minus 1. Okay, we know this is cosec square y minus 1, that will be cot y. Okay, and that will be square. So these are the 10 differentiation of cot inverse function, trigonometric functions, inverse functions as well. Okay, so I have done these 10, mostly trigonometric functions. Okay, by first, from first principle of from Ab initio. Now, I have taken these 10 questions, for 15 questions, in the next lecture, where the lecture will be very lengthy. Properly, I will take them. Okay, so that a pre-step can be understood by the student. Okay. For the student welfare, I will take that in the next lecture, not today. Okay, then see you next time.